weird.
First of all, thank you gentlemen for being here. Thank all of you. We're here for the signing of the Foreign Assistance Authorization Bill. It's the first one that I've had to sign since 1981. And I'm particularly pleased that the Congress has approved renewed aid to the Nicaraguan freedom fighters and replaced the so-called Clark Amendment, or repealed it, and provided support for the Philippines and Guatemala. I have my deep gratitude for that. These measures are important in signaling American resolve and support for freedom. And I must say the substantial reduction, however, in the support levels is security assistance has been disappointing. These reductions, plus the reduction in defense, I think reduces our effectiveness and the effectiveness of our foreign policy. And I realize that the budget pressures have been very severe. There's a general lack of enthusiasm for foreign aid, and that made the job more difficult. But we have to make the people aware that these programs are the most effective instruments we have for shaping a more secure international environment. And I hope that we can all work together in the months ahead to reinvigorate the program. And now I'm going to sign Senate Bill 960. No, there are two absentees here that I understand. All right, that does it.
Mr. President, what message have you given Mr. McFarland?
No. This is the purpose of this meeting here, and I'm not going to take any questions now on this photo opportunity to take away from this.
Well, let me try again on something else. Is the NSC directing any contra operations? And if so, is that a violation of the current law today prohibiting exchange of intelligence?
That's a question that kind of trapped me in one that we're not violating anymore.
Thank you for that. Situation, and there's